Hello, Internet! Is there anything worse than Monday? I don't think so. Okay, there is. But to all of you regular fellas out there, Monday is just the worst. A lot of stress at work, you hate your colleagues, and you are the furthest away from the weekend. To help you release some stress, I will pitch you a movie. So sit down, relax, grab something to eat, and enjoy. I am Andreas, here to make your movie experiences better. Today on Movie Monday, I bring you... Arrival. All the depth of a fortune cookie message with some sweet special effects. This movie is directed by Denis Villeneuve. So, this movie is directed by the director of Prisoners and Sicario. Those two movies were really great, so I had high hopes for this one. Before I watched this movie, I read some reviews, and some people were calling it the Thinking Man's Alien or Independence Day. But is it? Is this movie really that smart? Really? You know where I'm going with this. No, it's not.
Fuck you! Yeah, that's my message for you. Fuck you!
Don't stop watching my review. Wait till the end. Please. It is a quite simple movie, but the brilliance of it is that it makes you think that it's about more than it really is, and it does it perfectly. This is achieved by the visuals, editing, and acting. It is really hard to talk about this movie without spoilers, so in the end I might go into spoiler territory. So it's a warning in advance. The story starts by introducing us to Amy Adams' character, who plays Louise Banks, a linguist who is recruited by the military to help in the communication with aliens. Because, you know, 12 alien spacecrafts appear around the world. No big deal, you know. We have a military commander who is played by Forrest Whitaker, who tries his best to make sure things doesn't escalate. He plays his part really well, but at this point in his career, we didn't expect anything else but a great performance. There are a lot of movies that present this type of character, the military commander in charge, but Whitaker makes it his own by making him a bit like a soldier with some business perspective. Thanks to his portrayal, his character doesn't feel like such a big cliché. Oh, and also there's Hawkeye in the movie, for reasons. He is good in the movie, but he doesn't add anything to the story. The movie has beautiful imagery, so much so that the whole experience feels real. Now, the movie has practically no action in it, but it's not needed at all. The story is trying to focus on the human side, if such an event were to happen. Via news and eyewitness reports, we get a glimpse of how fear and panic starts to spread the longer the aliens are on the planet, even though they haven't done anything. To being able to communicate, our leads try to teach our language to the two aliens they come in contact with. By the way, the aliens look really great in this movie, so props to that. So while the leads try to find out why the aliens are here, the world slowly starts to panic. Because reasons, I guess. If I say more, I go into spoilers territory, and I don't just wanna do that yet. I give it that though. Up until the end, the movie keeps you on the edge, it makes you think and guess why they arrived. It is again a great directorial move, but then there is the ending. We find out why they are here and what they want, and nothing is done about that idea. Just the end credits. Okay, I guess this is the spoiler part, so spoiler warning. Instead of that really interesting idea of time not being linear, thanks to the aliens' language, we are left with one message. That people need to talk and work together. Well, no shit, Sherlock. That's it. It fits on a fortune cookie. And this is disappointing. This movie had so much going for it. Great visuals, great acting, an interesting premise, almost without any sci-fi cliches. Oh, by the way, if Hollywood could stop this bullshit with some military personnel going rogue and trying to kill the aliens themselves, that would be great. I like the style of the director. His previous movies I've seen were really good, but this one is a hit and miss. Not to say that this is a bad movie. It's a good movie, just not a smart movie. Or at least not as smart as it wants to be. They put more effort in explaining how you can breathe on the spaceship than in the overall message. Maybe it was false advertising or too high expectations that made this movie a disappointment for me. All things considered, I will give it a watch it once label or a 7 out of 10. This movie had a few things going for it, so if you don't expect it to leave you thinking for days, you might have a good time with this one. I will leave a link for the trailer down below. Have you seen this movie? What did you think about this movie? Do you agree with me? Did I miss something? Whatever it is, comment below. And if you liked my video, give it a thumbs up. And as always, thank you for watching.